March 26th, Chinon. It is one thing for a band of dispirited soldiers to put their trust in a teenage girl. It is entirely another for that girl to be given command of the army of an entire nation. We were filled with pride when we heard the Dauphin's heralds pronounce Joan the Maid as commander of the army of France. So that she may look like a general, the Dauphin presented Joan with a great war horse and a suit of white armor. Joan instructed me to look for an ancient sword buried beneath the altar of a local church. I was skeptical, but not only did the men unearth a rusted blade, but we found that the sword belonged to Charlemagne, grandfather of France. I shall not doubt her word again. Still visible on the hilt was the fleur-de-lis. Joan adopted the fleur-de-lis as her symbol and had it blazoned upon her battle standard. Wherever Joan goes, the standard goes also. It goes with us to Orléans. The city of Orléans is one of the finest in France, but it is under siege by our enemies, England and Burgundy, and is about to fall. This war has dragged on for 100 years with precious few French victories. The people of Orléans need a savior. They are to get Joan of Arc.
I am the Duc d'Alençon, my lady. I will proudly ride with you to Orléans. Our city needs help. The British are coming.
Bonne chance, John! Is yours to command. To Orléans. We need to get some supplies past the British.
Thank you.
Joan the Maid has come. We are saved. Hurrah! Joan of Arc has brought us supplies. Now we can muster the forces we need to raise one of the British castles.
Oh,
Shall not stop us.
The Duke d'Anchon has fallen in battle.
Thank you. Jefe! Oye él. Prêt.
Certes. Oui, mais... Oil.
Thank you.